I'm joined here today by one of the most fascinating people on the planet, me. I'm gonna ask some tough questions here. Figure out what exactly is your legacy, President Bush. If you had to sum up your presidency in one word, what would that word be?
I think I can describe it in two, and that would be tenacious and awesome. And if we put those together, that becomes tenawesome.
Tenawesome. I like that.
Yeah.
You are tenawesome.
Yeah, that's good.
Who's the one world leader you're going to miss the most?
The guy I'm going to miss the most is Vlad Putin. First time I met Putin, I stared right into his eyes, through his eyes, into the back of his skull.
Mm-hmm.
And he said, "What's up? Why are you looking at me like that?" And I just said, "I'm staring into your soul."
That makes me think, do you ever use that as a diplomatic strategy, creeping out on purpose other world leaders?
Because sometimes you have to creep out another world leader just to show them who's boss. You know who taught me the most about creeping people out? Cheney.
Yeah, he's a creepy one.
I mean, that guy's creepy.
He's first-team All-American creepy.
For the longest time, I thought the White House was haunted.
Right.
I wouldn't leave my bedroom after 9:30 at night. Turns out it was Cheney wandering around in there, banging on things and walking around with, like, a gas lantern, looking for stuff. And I'm like, what are you doing, man?
Where do you think he got a lantern?
I don't know. Lynn Cheney is a big collector of antiques, lanterns and antique pistols, old dresses from the prairie.
I remember I once saw Cheney naked in the shower. That creeped me out.
He's just a creepy dude.
Creeped me out and made me sick to my stomach. He just looked at me, let out a high-pitched scream. It shattered all the windows in the bathroom, and then he disappeared.
Yeah.
Just like that. Like a shapeshifter.
Yeah.
Okay, enough with the easy questions. Let me ask you something. Some might consider a little below the belt. Are you really the decider?
Yeah, I'm a decider.
Okay, I get it, you are. Because I have decision-making abilities that allow me to think of thoughts and have it transfer through my brain, out my mouth hole, and then into your ears.
I heard it, that was high and tight.
And that's what the decider does. You know, there was another name. There's a variation of the decider called the choicer, but then I settled on the decider. Sounds a little more learned.
Did they ever let you drive Air Force One?
You know, I was always like, give me a poke at the controls, and when are you going to let me drive this bird? And they were like, never.
Right.
No, we're just kidding, Mr. President, but honestly, you're not allowed to do that. And I said, guys, enough's enough. I'm flying this airplane. And immediately got us into trouble. We went straight into a nosedive. Then they had to wrestle me from the controls and get the plane back to cruising altitude. And the guy said, look, I know I could get fired for saying this, but if you ever do anything like this again, I have to shoot you. Then you said, I'm president. And I'm like, what do you mean? Like with like a, it's like, no, I have to, this pistol that I carry, I got to shoot you. And he said, am I getting fired? And I said,
sure.
Yeah, you're getting fired for that. He had that look in his eye. He had that pissed off look.
Really?
And he wasn't blinking at all.
These guys are serious.
Yeah. What are you going to take from the White House? I think a fun kind of keepsake from my years at the White House, I'd like to take one of those, just a toilet.
You're going to take a whole toilet?
From one of the bathrooms.
Huh.
Yeah.
I would not have thought to take a toilet. I'm probably going to take a big ticket item, you know, maybe a fancy portrait or something. Maybe James Madison.
That's a rich, meaty, juicy answer. Thank you. Now I'm going to look you in the eye and ask you one of the toughest questions I can think of. Who do you love more, Laura Bush or Barbara Bush?
I'd have to say more in the way that you look at someone and they scare you like in a Halloween costume. That's the respect I have for Barbara because she scares the shit out of me.
You're not pulling any punches. You're bringing the real stuff.
I have so much respect / fear for my mother that I sleep with a golf club in my bed.
Really?
Because sometimes she'll just barge in and it's my mom, but at first I think it's a creature.
Do you know what else is also an effective weapon? Fire extinguisher. Because you can either just spray them back or if the canister runs empty, you can use that big heavy metal thing as a missile, a projectile. That's something else to think about.
Yeah.
The other thing about Barbara is she's built. She's very muscular.
She's very muscular.
Yeah, she's scary.
She did a lot of lat work in her youth, and she's still got some pretty strong lats.
She's built like a shit brick house.
I think there was some Greek philosopher who said the lat is, you know, the muscle that controls the body.
God, you are fascinating. What's your single greatest moment you experienced in the White House?
There was this one afternoon in 2003, and I had about a 2.5 hour nap that was just, it was perfect. It was just right in the sweet spot.
Those are good.
You know, we wake up and you got a little bit of drool on the pillow, and you know, you almost wake up in a haze because you went so deep.
Were you kind of sweaty? Was it one of those naps?
Had a little bit of a sexy dream, but not too sexy, where I had to change my pants.
Yeah.
That was a moment. I knew something special had happened.
Oh, you went deep.
Had a plaque made commemorating the nap, the duration, the date.
Sure.
Bronze plaque on a yeah. mounted on some burled mahogany with an outer edge of cherry and a little bit of ash.
Tell me, what are your favorite kinds of woods?
It depends on my mood. Sometimes I like just a simple wood, like pine, a burnished pine.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, nothing looks better than that.
I could not have said it better myself.
Other times, I love oak, an oak plank. Sometimes I'll look at an oak plank and I'll just stare at it and talk to it and say, I wish you could tell me stories about your life as a tree, but you can't now because someone yeah. carved you up into a plank.
That's the way it is.
Uh-huh.
You know what wood I hate?
Let me guess. Balsa wood.
Exactly.
Balsa wood's stupid.
Yeah.
So flimsy.
It doesn't feel like a real wood.
Yeah.
It's kind of like if you had steel, the consistency of clay, then is it really steel?
Well, when you put it that way, it makes a lot of sense.
Yeah.
It is like the coward of woods.
What trees do balsa wood come from? Never seen a balsa wood tree. I never heard the phrase, hey, let's go take a trip to the balsa wood forest.
The other wood that I don't care for is bamboo.
Right. Because it's not even a wood.
Bamboo's lately been cocky.
Yeah. No, I know.
Everyone's getting like a bamboo hardwood floor. I'm like, that's not wood.
I know.
And now bamboo thinks it's wood. And, you know, it pisses me off.
That's something communists hide behind.
Yeah. Tell me about it.
Communists and panda bears. Mm. You know? Hide behind that stuff.
Yeah.
You've consulted the Almighty on many occasions.
I did, sure.
If you had a chance to sit down with him face to face, what would your words of advice be?
Well, I don't think I'm in a position to give advice to the Almighty.
Smart.
If I did have a moment with him, and I hope I do, I'd probably tell him to make sure you take time off.
That's prudent.
You know, I took the most vacation days of any president in history.
You look great.
40% of my time in office was spent at Camp David or at the ranch.
Must have been from all the rest.
And I would say, hey, God, make sure you recharge the batteries. Don't, you know, because you got a lot on your plate.
He's working around the clock 24-7, you know, something I could never do.
Uh-huh.
You talked about staying at Camp David. You make any changes there as president?
I built a 500-foot water slide called the Twister.
Sure. I heard of it.
You know, that thing will put hair on your balls.
Mm. No fun.
Also built the world's largest tank filled with piranha.
I respect that.
It's 27,000 cubic meters of water.
Impressive.
Last 4th of July, we had constructed a 10-foot Statue of Liberty out of baloney, and we loaded it down in.
It was kind of like a freedom beating frenzy, I imagine.
We watched them just go to town while we played background music.
It's an emotional image. If our founding fathers could look into a crystal ball and see that a president was doing something like that, I think they'd be proud. You should pat yourself on the back.
I would like that very much.
Do you feel like you've had to compromise any ideals as president?
One thing I would have done differently, that kick-ass flight suit that I wore on the carrier when we said mission accomplished, I would have worn that every day.
You know, I think had you done that, not only would it be a statement, but I think it would have been a fashion trend.
People said it looked stupid, but I know I look good.
Everyone loves someone in a uniform.
So I would have done that differently.
I picture a playground of 7 and 8 year olds all running around, climbing on jungle gyms, laughing, all in flight suits.
Oh,
That's my vision of America.
God, that's good. I probably would have changed it up more. I would have probably done a few more press events shirtless.
Yeah.
Show off my fine physique.
You could have gotten some, you know, funny tattoo on your back, like a leprechaun, or
I might have done a little more weight training,
or just a big Japanese tiger on your back, and it's kind of like jumping out of your back, you know, onto people.
Yeah.
Maybe it could even be like a 3D thing. But you'd have to carry around a pair of 3D glasses, have people put it on to see the effect.
Yeah, that's good.
I'd pay money to see that.
That's real good.
If you could be any animal in the animal kingdom, what would you be?
I'd probably be, like a turkey vulture.
Hmm.
They're underrated.
Yeah, sure.
Because they're actually quite smart. They hunt in packs.
Remember when Laura at the ranch was doing some gardening and a group of turkey vultures descended upon her?
Well, it's very common, and they know what they're doing. They do it on purpose.
Took off all her clothing.
Yeah.
Well, it was kind of odd.
They'll circle women and rip their clothes off.
It was frightening and beautiful all at the same time.
Sure. They get so big that you can actually ride them. If you sneak up on them, you got to learn how to do it. You got to walk on the balls of your feet and get real low. You can get on the back.
I love it.
They'll take you for about a half a mile.
I absolutely love it.
Yeah.
Love what you're saying.
And they're trying to get you off their back, too. They don't like it.
Of course not. It's a wild animal.
But that's something that's worth doing.
The other day, I saw this van with a beautiful mural on the side with a naked lady and a puma kind of draped kind of down by her feet. And I'd like to be that puma, if you catch my drift.
Hey, Ma,
are you falling asleep?
Go on. No, I'm with you.
I think you're falling asleep.
Mm-mm. Get out of here, man.
Anyway, if I gotta hunt, I gotta hunt. Like, I'm not just gonna hang out with the lady the whole time, mm-hmm. But...
Then...
Hey, wake up.
Get the... Where's my golf club?
You did it again. You fell asleep right when I was...
Well, you know, I apologize on one hand. On the other hand, if I fell asleep, that either means I needed the sleep or your stories are boring.
Well, I want to thank you for this.
Thank you.
For spending the time, for taking the time. It's been a unique experience, to say the least.
That is hilarious. Hey, we got to hang out sometime.
Let's try to make this, you know, a regular happening.
Hey, I'm
if we can.
God knows I'll be free.